Kenson and his wife Symbol aren't that different from parents across Australia. They're homeowners who work hard to feed their family and give their kids a good education. Unlike most Australian mums and dads, they don't have jobs, a mortgage, or even a bank account. In fact, like 80% of the population in Vanuatu, they have very little need for money at all.
The only thing that we need money for is to pay for that salt so that it can give taste to our local foods, and then to make sure that our kids go to school with clean clothing. Then we need soap, and then we need kerosene to be poured into our lamps so that we could be able to eat at night with a little bit of light.
According to the United Nations, Vanuatu is classed as a least developed country. But poverty is relative. No one goes hungry here. They live on their ancestral land, collect rainwater for drinking and washing, and grow, fish, and hunt for their food. Not everything's free, but when they need money to pay for their children's school fees, they can literally make their own.
I pay my school fees in weaving mats like this one, the one I'm doing. What I do is I get them ready, and then I get them up to school, and then I pay for the school fee with mat.
Villagers here and in many parts of Vanuatu can now pay medical bills and school fees with food they grow and with ceremonial wealth items like mats and pigs. In North Pentecost, this mat isn't just worth money, it is money, a traditional or custom currency. When someone needs an extra mat for a custom ceremony, they'll know where to come to buy one.
Custom activity inside local community happen all time. It happen all time. Same death and marriage, more custom ceremony, more make them beast with them narrow one. So you look all same. Baba you meet them all same. You same say me value lo custom mat lo life lo people. Hemi big one bit him cash, money.
Most economists have no conception whatsoever that other economic systems exist in the world besides theirs, and that have existed probably from before any of the current nations in Europe were ever founded.
Anthropologist Kirk Huffman spent 12 years as curator of the Vanuatu Cultural Centre.
Things are incredibly rare. This is fossilised clamshell money from the island of Eromango.
He's now a research associate at the Australia Museum in Sydney.
This is blood money. This is worth a human life.
This may be some of the rarest kind of money in the world. This is incredibly rare red feather money. And I think there may only be a very few people in the world, maybe less than half a dozen, in the world who have the knowledge and the rights to make this type of currency.
The most valuable currency in much of Vanuatu is pig.
Have a look at these circular pig's tusks from northern central and northern Vanuatu. This is early collections.
Pigs with special tusks are sacrificed in custom ceremonies.
But this, just look at this one. Look at this one. This is just, this pig was probably so sacred that it may have been, even been too sacred to sacrifice in ritual.
Sacred and an extreme pain. To grow a pig that's long in the tooth, other teeth have to be pulled out, so the curling tusks can penetrate the pig's upper jaw.
So why has the pig become the Melanesian equivalent of the gold standard?
In certain cultures within Vanuatu, the relationship between man and pigs is so close that without the involvement of pigs in your life, you can never, after death, get to the world of the spirits. And so it's only normal in a way that pigs would develop into a certain type of currency, a sacred currency, money with legs.
I'm 10,000 Vatu. I'm now Bobby Pia. I look task plan, I'm going to penda, I'm going to little bit cotton, yeah?
The local school charges market rates for these, between $100 and $200 each.
I'm Mambu, 15,000 Vatu. I'm looking.
Bringing home the bacon on Pentecost means men like Kenson spend years nurturing the family pigs. This one's now worth about $200.
From some time, if you soon blow them woman lamb, especially if you them school vinal or to blame.
You have six daughters, Simbal.
Yes.
And you will get a lot of pigs when they get married?
Absolutely right. 10 pigs per daughter.
Are you looking forward to this?
Yes, of course. Hopefully some of the kids won't die. Just by under my care, I hopefully that I have 60 pigs by the time they're all grown up.
So the daughters, they are also valuable because they are the key to getting more pigs?
Yes, absolutely. So I'm a fortunate mother with six kids. Yeah. Daughters, I mean.
And the son, you have to pay pigs for him to get married.
I have to pay 10 pigs for him to get married, so that minus 60 pigs, and then I'm left with 50 pigs.
You'll be a very happy old lady.
Yes, thank you, Amos.
On the east coast of North Pentecost, faith in the custom economy has led to a financial revolution. Traditionally, only the tusks on a live pig are valuable, or on the skull of a pig that hasn't been sacrificed. But here, the tusks themselves have become objects of great value. And they've built a bank to store them.
Me, you meeting say mabai lo future, custom bank blue you me mabai me work together with them every foreign bank around the world. Long help them everyone. Lo side blue economy.
Chief Virileo Bobaren Vanua says 10,000 people from Pentecost and neighbouring islands have deposited their custom wealth here. He's invented a new unit of exchange, the levatu, to measure the value of pig tusks. He issues bank books and even check books that can be used at some of the island's shops. Concepts of credit, debit, and even compound interest do exist in the custom economy. But critics accuse Chief Virileo of distorting custom and question the choice of a currency that's only found in some parts of Vanuatu.
Suppose life law wall let me change, but you know current custom blue you belong, you make him belong him state with them life, but my custom blue you, but by him save it.
According to his own valuation, Chief Virileo says the bank's custom assets are worth 1.4 billion Australian dollars. But he's not worried about thieves.
Only thing say, suppose for example, suppose you want you come blue steel, lo blesia. Ata suppose all custom security ba oliko limi ba you no sabe. By money no look track blow all keta lo you. Say ah money oli bin situm. From we want them go inside here. Oli kamu oli look you date you stop. Ba oli no sabe say you date lo one mi me demio. Say mana I'm a custom security.
Chief Viraleo has effectively been printing his own money. Now he wants a license to make it official. He's called upon the government and Reserve Bank to recognise his custom currency and agree to a fixed rate of exchange with the national currency, the Vatu. Do you see Chief Viraleo as a champion of tradition or as a savvy capitalist?
As an innovator with a capitalist tinge, but many of the cultures in that part of Vanuatu are traditionally capitalist in a Melanesian way.
Vanuatu's economic direction is hotly contested at the moment. National elections are being held later in the year, and politicians have come under fire for agreeing to join the World Trade Organization, or WTO.
What am I, Fradlin? Mimi no look any reason, but let me tell you one example. Suppose one big problem because of Mimi Vanuatu, small country, I won't buy one of my Mimi. Mimi must join them or be people a trading partner. From where, what them small voice, Luya, only Sabe Haremantap.
The push to get Vanuatu to join the World Trade Organization is a very good example of this having to choose where do we go in Vanuatu.
Ralph Reganvanu is an opposition MP and former cabinet minister who's championed support for the custom economy.
We are promoting an economy which basically exists in 20% of the country or affects 20% of the population.
Ham Leni is currently deputy prime minister and brother of the late Walter Leni, Vanuatu's independence hero. When he was Prime Minister, he declared 2007 to be the year of the traditional economy.
No thinking no more. Come was under this time, you got one commitment, we got money, we got thinking, maybe some help a little bit, we can work here, come and up. But then, by custom currency, we have no demand, we have no command, we have no demand, we can work, we have no more.
Good morning.
Hello, good morning,
Ham,
Deputy Prime Minister.
Thank you, Thomas. Time we come to today, I'm looking at you. You got one issue, I'm rice. Where I'm needing one try head, blow pick, blow one custom ceremony.
Whatever its role in the country's political life, the Deputy Prime Minister embraces the custom economy in his personal life. As the world frets about the fragility of its financial system, supporters of Vanuatu's custom economy say it isn't a relic from the past. It represents hope for the future.
Vanuatu is very fortunate because we can still imagine a different sort of society, a different sort of economy, a different sort of way of living. That is not what the rest of the world has gone, well, most of the rest of the world has gone into. The local economy idea, the green economy idea, we already have it.
Or somewhere, crisis will stop. Vanuatu hemi harem. But at the same time too, Vanuatu hemi ready. Them ready belong teach him all Naravala country suppose only need him help belong find him good for the road to life. So I think, thank you too much.